I was really appalled of watching Democrats' actions today to delay it to get to a shutdown. But when we found that an individual elected to Congress would pull a fire alarm, that's a new low. We watched how people have been treated if they've done something wrong in this Capitol. It'd be interesting to see how he is treated on what he was trying to obstruct when it came to the American public.
Strong words for progressive Democratic Representative Jamaal Bowman coming from Republican House Speaker Kevin McCarthy. This is in regard to Jamaal Bowman pulling a fire alarm as the House was set to vote on a stopgap measure to keep the government funded through mid-November. Now, everything happened very quickly over the weekend. We were barreling toward the deadline to fund the government, and Democrats wanted to be able to read the legislation before signing on to it. And so they were trying to stall. So that environment kind of led to the allegations that Representative Bowman is facing now. So it was later determined through a photo that was released that Representative Jamaal Bowman had in fact triggered that alarm. Let me give you more details about it. Well, first off, that's the photo that was released by Republicans. They did not release any footage, which I think is a little weird and questionable. I think it would have been a lot more illuminating if we had footage of what happened. How long was he standing there? Now, the reason why I say that is because of what Jamaal Bowman claims happened and how that conflicts with the Republican Party's interpretation of what happened. According to the New York Times, Bowman pulled a fire alarm in the House Cannon office building, prompting an evacuation of the building and investigations by the Capitol Police and the House Administration Committee. Now, the alarm was triggered at the same time that House Democrats at the Capitol, okay, we're stalling a vote on a spending measure to keep the government operating for another 45 days. Speaker McCarthy had unveiled the bill just minutes earlier, and Democrats were scrambling to read the bill and determine whether to support it. I just love how dysfunctional our government is, right? They just dilly-dally until the last minute, okay? They play games until the last minute. And then there's a piece of legislation that members of Congress feel pressured to vote in favor of before they can even freaking read it. I think that dysfunction is more infuriating than what Jamaal Bowman is being accused of here. I'm just gonna keep it real. Now, later in the day, that bill did in fact pass 335-91 with more Democrats voting in favor of it than Republicans, even though Republicans dominate the House of Representatives. Now, Bowman said that he had not pulled the alarm on purpose to delay the vote, as some Republicans have claimed. He said that he was actually rushing to the Capitol to cast a vote, and he came to a door in the Cannon building that would not open. He said, quote, "I am embarrassed to admit that I activated the fire alarm, mistakenly thinking it would open the door. I regret this and sincerely apologize for any confusion this caused. But I want to be very clear, this was not me in any way trying to delay any vote. It was the exact opposite. I was trying urgently to get to a vote." Now, he added that he met with the sergeant at arms and Capitol Police after the incident at their request to explain what had happened. And I want to provide one other thing. So apparently there was a sign there that he found confusing, okay? So let's take a look at the next graphic. And Matt Brunig explains what transpired allegedly. So the sign specifically reads, "Emergency exit only. Push until alarm sounds, 3 seconds. Door will unlock in 30 seconds. And Brunig says that Bowman was trying to walk from the Cannon building to the Capitol building to vote. Unusually, the Cannon exit he went to wouldn't open and had this confusing sign on it. He thought it was saying you had to press the alarm to get out. This all makes sense. What am I missing?" But Jake Tapper, while speaking to Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez over the weekend, made it clear that he ain't buying it. And I gotta be honest, AOC's defense of Bowman wasn't really all that aggressive. Let's watch.
Interesting moment over the weekend when your New York colleague, Congressman Jamaal Bowman, and he's under investigation for this now after Capitol Police say he pulled a fire alarm in one of the House office buildings. Democrats were trying to delay a vote, a final vote on the bill. There he is. Pulling the fire alarm. He says it was an accident. He thought pulling the alarm would open a door. based on the fact that the doors to his right there were locked, and there was a sign that he said he was, I think someone said it was confusing. I'll be honest, it doesn't really make sense to me, his explanation. Have you talked to him? What's going on
there? I mean, listen, I think if you actually do see some of the photos of the signs, I think there's something to be said about the government's about to shut down. There's a vote clock that's going down. The exits that are normally open in that building were suddenly closed.
So you pulled a fire alarm?
So what I am here to say is that House administration and US Capitol Police and Jamaal Bowman are in active, and he's fully participating in saying there was a misunderstanding.
So that was her defense, but clearly Jake Tapper isn't buying the explanation, and neither are opportunistic House Republicans who are using this as an opportunity to call for the expulsion of Representative Bowman. Here's a little taste of what they've been saying.
This is while an official proceeding is happening on the House floor. Well, let's talk about what that is. That's violating a law. That is the exact same law that January 6th defendants are being prosecuted by the Department of Justice every single day. They're rotting in jail every single day. And that is exactly what happened.
This is the same standard that the people from January 6th were held with. I want him to be held at the same standard. As a member of this body, I call for immediate consideration for everyone to look serious into his actions, and that he be held at the full extent of the law.
And I don't think that we should play the, you know, two-tier justice system where we're going to go ahead and throw our J6 guys under the bus whenever they came into the Capitol when they committed no violent crime, but yet we're going to let this guy obstruct federal process and just get away with it.
It was during an official proceeding. That is the same thing that they've gone after, you know, those individuals who walked into the Capitol on January 6th. You have to have an equal distribution of justice.
He's a Democrat, radical left lunatic. And he should be prosecuted the same exact way as the J6 people were prosecuted. Bowman went and he pulled an alarm, and you could add riots, you could add everything else, and he did it during a vote. And he should be treated the same exact way. And we'll see what happens, because a lot of people are saying, what are you going to do about J6? I don't think they're going to be disappointed, I can tell you that.
I mean, is Donald Trump even alive or breathing if he's not trying to sell tumblers or some other Trump campaign merchandise? Anyway, these are not serious people, and I'm so sick of the circus. Cenk, I gotta be honest, I don't care about the story at all, okay? I don't care if he did it on purpose or if it was an accident. It might have been an accident. If it was an accident, like, just read the signs a little more carefully. Who cares?
Yeah, I got you. But once the Republicans attack, you are either going to not defend, right? And then Jamaal Bowman's gonna look to be compared to guys pulling off a coup against the American government 24/7 on television, all over television, or you're going to defend him, and then you're in the middle of the circus. So we don't have a choice.
Jake,
so
we're looking at footage of January 6th. I think it's the same thing. Look at that footage.
Yeah,
same thing. Same thing.
Yeah. Okay. So look, if you can't tell that it's not pulling a fire alarm is not the same thing as a giant riot involving thousands of people where they were chanting "Hang Mike Pence," and they were trying to do a coup against the American government with a fake elector scheme, etc. Well, you have cognitive difficulties, and nothing I say will make a difference to you because you don't even understand words. So if you're that deeply biased, be gone, okay? But for the rest of you, I'm gonna defend Jamaal Bowman on the actual charge. When I first saw this, I thought to myself, I didn't know the defense at all, and I thought, man, that is awfully strange. Why the hell did he do that? And I was really frustrated in my mind because I couldn't think of any reason why you'd pull the fire alarm. And then I thought, you know, he was a principal. Is this some sort of thing about, like, you know, in a school, kids pull fire alarms if you're in an emergency? Did he think that? Then I read the explanation, and the explanation makes perfect sense. So put up that picture again, okay? So, and this is exactly the type of mistake I'd make, and you guys can judge me for it if you like to. So he gets to a door which normally opens for members like him. He's late to getting to a vote. He's trying to figure it out, and he reads the sign: emergency exit only. Push until alarm sounds. 3 seconds. It makes it sound like, don't worry, the alarm's only gonna sound for 3 seconds. Then door will unlock in 30 seconds. It's an instruction manual on what to do with the alarm so that the door opens. At a bare minimum, the world's worst sign. The dumbest, craziest sign I've ever seen, right? So you could say, hey, Cenk, you're a knucklehead. That doesn't mean pull the fire alarm. I don't know which alarm it's referring to. Okay, fine, guilty as charged. That I'm telling you right now, I probably would have done the same thing. And so is it embarrassing? It's super embarrassing. Because if you think about it for a second, yeah, it's a fire alarm. Of course, don't pull the fire alarm. What alarm are they talking about? Why isn't this door working? But he's rushing to the vote. So guys, we're going to have definitive evidence and the Capitol Police should release this video. Because they've only released a picture, right? So show us the video. If he goes and he just pulls the fire alarm, then I'm wrong. No, he meant to pull the fire alarm, etc. If he's looking around, reading a sign, looking confused, and then pulls the fire alarm, then you'll know that he was telling the truth. So release the video and let's be done with this insanity. But Anna, what drives me crazy is everything in politics is marketing. So the minute they start attacking and doing this insane false equivalency, it forces us into this conversation. So we're in one nonsense conversation after another, after another, after another, because Republicans scream from the rooftops with insanity every day and make people believe it. And the Democrats usually whimper in return. By the way, another giant difference between Jamaal Bowman, I mean, I can't believe I'm even entertaining this, but he's working with Capitol Police and Sergeant at Arms as we speak right now, and he did from minute one. If you were looking to do anything that was amiss, you're not going to be looking to work with the authorities to get a conclusion on this matter. But hey, if you want to be biased and you want to attack Bowman, you were going to do that anyway, no matter what he did. Keep it real.
Yeah, look, I'm not surprised that some members of the Republican Party are grasping at straws to paint a picture of Democrats that makes it appear as though they engage in the same type of criminality that some Republican lawmakers have engaged in, especially when it comes to attempts to overturn the 2020 presidential election. Maybe not criminality, but certainly bad behavior, the willingness to reject the results of the 2020 election, the fact that they endlessly provide cover for Trump's alleged crimes day in and day out. I mean, George Santos wants to open his mouth about wrongdoing and bad behavior? That criminal, that guy? Yeah, how about you shut up, sit down and have some freaking decency, get yourself a decent suit if you're gonna be a sitting member of the House of Representatives, a position that he does not deserve as someone who lied to the American people, lied to his constituents, and is a complete and utter fraudster. Disgusting. Anyway.
Yeah, so Anna, look, I thought the same thing about George Santos. I'm like, man, this guy's got some nerve. And like acting as if he's outraged. I mean, Republicans, aren't you humiliated by now? This guy committed how many different crimes, lied to you in every conceivable way. And then you're gonna let him pretend that he's outraged by Jamaal Bowman making a mistake on an alarm? Get out of here, man. And you know, as I was watching that, I was thinking, that's like the perfect symbol of the theater of American politics.
1,000%, 1,000%.
Right? Yep. Just a total actor. Look, if you, again, if you're not already convinced, Jonathan Turley, who's now a diehard Trump supporter and Fox News legal analyst, today on Fox News was like expelling him. It's like, that's madness. There's only been 5 members of Congress ever expelled in hundreds of years. And he's like, over a fire alarm? He's like, well, then everybody's gonna get expelled and there'll be no end to this. And so even diehard Trump supporters are like, can you guys please cut the crap and move on, please?
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.